Sedona Airport.
Automated weather observation. 1742 Zulu weather. Wind 140 at Niner. Gusts 17. Visibility 10. Clear below 12,000. Temperature 26 Celsius. Dew point 1. Altimeter 3015. Remarks. Density altitude 6,900.
Density altitude 7,000 feet. It's gusting to 17, and we're going to go show us some high density altitude flying today. Hey everyone, Jason Schapper here at MzeroA.com alongside Hunter, great CFI that works for us, helps out with all our customer support. We're going to show some, we've been showing some mountain flying. We're going to show a lap in the pattern today at Sedona off the tabletop, as it's known, the Mesa, which really, you're if you're not flying by the end, you will be. If you're ready for it or not, it is a windy day. We're taking off downhill, which is beneficial, but wait till you see how that affects us on the landing. Wait till you see the difference between indicated and true and everything else. So it's going to be interesting. I'm the flying pilot. Hunter's going to serve as my talking pilot. He's going to help me with the run-up once we get up here, and we're going to show something a little different during the run-up. We'll do our whole run-up, Hunter, and then we'll show how we lean appropriately and everything else for that.
Sounds good.
In the 7,000 feet of density altitude that we're dealing with, so. All right, I'm just going to, oh, there's a little run-up area here, enough room, and no one's coming behind us, just that helicopter, so we'll be all right. And that is what I mean when I say, if you're not flying by the end of it, you will be. And then that's, we got to clear that little hump there, too. So this is going to be interesting. I'm going to turn into the wind just for everything else. No one's behind us here. We're all good. So, Hunter, if you want to run me through that run-up checklist, please.
All right, we'll go through before takeoff checklist.
All right.
Parking brake, we'll set.
All right, you mind getting it for me?
Yeah, there we go.
Thank you.
Passenger seat backs and seat belts secure.
Good, good.
All right, cabin doors closed and locked.
Good, but I'll leave my window open for now.
All right, flight controls free and correct.
Hey, right side up, left side down, left side up, right side down, full back, full forward. Everything looks great.
And flight instruments, we'll check our altimeters. So I've got 3015.
3015 confirmed.
Confirmed. By flight instruments while we're down here.
All
check
right.
Those look good. And we'll check our fuel quantity.
Hey, looks great.
Hey, fuel selector valve.
All right, both confirmed.
With a mixture control rich.
All right, well, again, in this situation,
right.
It's a little different. We'll talk about that in a bit here.
50 is about turning 10 mile per
right.
hour runway.
And the biggest thing here, Jason, is I like more mixture as required, and this is the perfect place
yes.
for that.
Yes.
All right, let's do a throttle 1,800 RPM.
Okay, coming up. All right, 1,800, roughly.
All right, we'll do a magneto check.
Get it for me?
Here, so
thank
check
you.
The left. Sounds good. Check the right.
Good. Everything's set.
Check our vacuum indicator.
All right. Back's good.
Back is good.
Fresh temp. Everything's good.
Good. And we'll check idle.
All right. And back to idle. All right. Bell check is good. Now, what I want to show here is I want to show you can't go full rich, as we know, on this takeoff. We were just talking to the airport manager. He said, when you make a video, man, please show everybody how to properly lean. So let me show you guys. All right, let's shut the windows just because it's going to get real gusty quick. What I recommend is I'm leaned out about an inch. Let's just call it right now, okay? There's no science to that part. What I want to do is I'm going to go full power here. I'm holding the brakes. Park brake is set. Hunter, you got me on the brakes as well?
Yeah, I got your brakes.
I'm going to go full power. Holding the brakes, and I'm going to lean out, and you're going to see an increase in RPMs. It's already going up, and I'm going to go until I start to get a decrease. Now I'm getting a decrease. I'll bring it in just a hair from there, back up to that highest point I saw, about 23. If I give it too much and it starts going down, I'll have a problem again. There, 2350 is what I was showing, so I'm perfect right there. That's how you lean out. If you went full rich right now, you would not get maximum performance out of your aircraft. Let's make a radio call. I heard that helicopter talking. I got something way out there. I don't know where he's He's going.
I see him as well. Go ahead and make a radio call here.
Sedona traffic, MZ 850, 5 mile final, or runway 3, Sedona.
5 mile final for runway 3, so we will...
We'll wait for him.
We are absolutely going to wait for him here just a second.
And give him a call,
let him know we're holding short.
Okay. And Sedona traffic, Cessna 1097 November is holding short runway 21 for landing traffic, Sedona.
While he lands, we'll cut this video and we'll catch up with you guys. All right, he's clear now. Argo, and again, it's not his. Not like he chose the wrong runway. We were just talking about like the. It's a direct crosswind, and it's not going to be exciting. So, Hunter, no laughing at my landing. All right, let's do. I'm glad we spotted him. Let's just for giggle this way as well. Make another radio call if you don't mind.
It's Sedona traffic, Cessna 1097 November is holding short runway 21. We departing runway 21 for left traffic, Sedona.
That helicopter, and that's about it.
Yep.
We're leaned out, fuel, everything's set. I'm using every bit of runway. You guys have seen enough MzeroA videos to know my habit. I'm going backwards to use every bit of legal runway. Let's swing through and use some of that inertia. We're going downhill, so that certainly helps. And we're full power. I am showing true airspeed, but no indicated airspeed just yet. And this is where it starts to psych you out, where you're getting the ground rush, thinking you're ready to fly, but your indicator says 37.
Over there to your right, go ahead and pick whichever one you want.
Here we go. Oh, 1,000 feet. Not too shabby. It's the benefits of being leaned out. Look how it crabbed right away. You feel that?
Right, yep, just right to the wind.
And like I said, if you're not flying by the end, you'll see exactly what I meant here in just a second. Looking good, wow. A beautiful place to fly, a little intimidating and humbling all at the same time. Should climb that well, I'm showing 400 feet per minute.
Oh, not bad.
Good, engine gauges, everything's looking great. Really getting max RPM. I'm gonna turn my crosswind a little early just to be inside of this thing here, so if you don't mind making a crosswind call.
Yeah, we'll do that. Sedona traffic, Cessna 1097 November is turning left crosswind, runway 21, Sedona.
And that's, you know, 100, 200 feet too early, but I do not want to be over that thing. If something, you know, let's keep it over the lesser terrain, you know what I mean?
Well, a big thing here too is with all the mountains and terrain, I mean, it's just like water going over rapids. The air's the same way, and you get those gusts.
Great point. Yeah. Point. Those updrafts, those downdrafts. Looking back at the airport, gosh, that's pretty. All right, and I'm gonna keep my downwind inside of this too, because the same thing. That looks like two goalposts to go through, but at the same time, that's dangerous. You want to call my downwind here.
Sedona traffic, Skyhawk 1097 November is turning left downwind for 21 Sedona.
And again, like, am I a little, you know, did I turn downwind early? Absolutely I did, but look at that. I'm not flying directly over that. That's got updrafts and downdrafts written all over it. I'd rather kind of fly and drift out this way a little bit, knowing the wind wants to push me back this way too, so the wind's gonna be coming off of this way anyways. So I already got the odds stacked against me here. Here comes my, now that's 1,000 feet AGL. You look straight down to the ground, you go, oh, we're a little high, but you look at the runway and you go, no, that's where we need to be. Bringing some power back here. Everything else is set. I've got a gnarly little crab angle in here. I'm worried about going past this right here, just the eddy off of that. So I'm kind of bracing for that. I'm showing 104 on the true and 90 on the indicated.
About a 10 knot difference on your true and indicated.
And that's going to play a big role coming into land here. Power's coming back. It'd be my touchdown point. And I'm going 10 degrees of flaps. This girl coming down. There she goes. She went, oh, I'm kind of feeling
see, there go those rapids right there.
Oh, wow. My bottom left the seat on that one.
And I got a helicopter traffic off the left wing.
Inside. And again, I need to turn my base before this stuff, 200.
Right.
So
yeah.
I don't mean to fly such a tight pattern, but.
Sedona traffic, Skyhawk 1097 November is left base, runway 21, full stop, Sedona.
Woo, hee-haw. Wow, I can't catch a break here. I get this thing down, but I'm just catching updraft after updraft. I got this turn, I gotta get 20 degrees of flaps in here. This will challenge your skills, no doubt. And it's this silly little hump right here at the end that makes me a little nervous too. And I'm showing 72 indicated right now, and my heart is racing. Like, Jason, why are you 72 on base? But, you know, it's you got the true airspeed there to back it up.
There's a lot to think about with these landings.
Oh. Got some power here.
All right, final is clear.
Final is clear. Those flaps helped a lot. I'm really,
absolutely.
I feel like I gained a little more control of this thing. I'm having to give it some power now to keep it going. I'm still showing 82.
Yeah.
True.
Sedona traffic, Skyhawk 1097 November is turning final runway 21, Sedona.
Look at that crab angle.
Right. Two, right after we go over this hill, I mean, it's going to shift again.
Same thing.
Yep.
Well, you saw there's three windsocks at this airport, and all three are shown like 90 degrees apart from each other. Looking good. Runway's clear. I'm looking at like that third chevron there. On the,
yeah.
I feel like I am a little fast here. Easy to do. Easy to get slow. A little easier to go fast in this case because it psychs you out a little bit. But God, get slow quick too. And then I'm landing downhill, so makes it a little difficult. What's my speed right now, Hunter?
77 to true. Woo. Yeah, there goes that
turn
coming in.
Rock and roller coaster. Come on, girl. Gosh. Come on, girl. Yeehaw. Oh. Wow. A little aerodynamic brake. You might get my flaps for
me. Yeah, flaps are coming up, and aerodynamic braking.
That is teamwork right there, huh?
Right there.
Wow.
And we're rolling out here at the 2,000-foot marker, so you can see high density altitude, really in challenging wind conditions, takes almost 3,000 feet of runway.
But that's the thing. People think, like, oh, it's the take. I mean, granted, the takeoffs are scary.
Right.
But when you're landing downhill with a 17-knot crosswind, 7,000 feet of density altitude, the airplane did not want to touch down.
Not at all.
There was no reason for it to. And then every time I thought I was going to touch down, the runway sloped away from me. You want to get a call? We're clear.
All right.
Sedona traffic, Skyhawk 1097 November is clear runway 21, Sedona.
All right, guys, I am excited to read your comments on that video. Can't wait to hear some more of your mountain flying, some of your high density altitudes, some of your Sedona stories. Can't wait to read those. So listen, enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
I wrote the Private Pilot Blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit PrivatePilotBlueprint.com to get your free copy.